Back to my channel friends, and today I am super excited to share this MDF album. Yes, it's a mini MDF album, the tag album, which I have just finished, and I am super excited to share this with you all because I really wanted to make this album since long, and finally I got the time. And here how is it look? So I have done so much of work, the background stamping, the paper layering, the embellishment sticking, and inner pages are empty because you can have your pictures, you can do journaling, you can do whatever you want. You can give this to your friends, or this is just going to be a perfect gift for your loved one. So let's get started and learn how to make this. Welcome back to my channel friends, this side Sonia here, and today I have these MDF tags and I thought I'll create mini album with this. Yes, with these three tags. So what I'm going to do is I have already pre-cut these paper strips. It's approximately 1 inches by 1.5 inches, and I'm going to stick this on my paper. Now this is going to be my binding strips. This is going to bind my MDF tags, and that's the reason I have chosen tacky tape, because I really really like tacky tapes when you have to stick something very hard and stiff for longer time. So I'm putting up my tacky tape. It's a 1/2 inch tacky tape which fits perfectly to my paper strip, and I've already done a scoring here. You can see this is to make the fold, and I am going to peel it off and stick it to my tags. So whenever you're using your tacky tape, be a little careful because they stick anywhere and everywhere. So you need to be a little particular when you are sticking that. So now what I'm going to do is I am going to peel it off, stick it on one side of the base. I just need to make sure that it's almost at the center. Then I'm going to fold it down. I'm going to align two of my tags, and then I'm going to stick it to the paper, and with this my one fold is ready. So this is my first hinge. I think actually I need only two of these. So now for the third one, I'm going to again stick it to one of my base, fold it, remove the tape, and align it in a line and stick it well, press it really really well, and you can see my album base is ready. Now you need to make sure that you press this really well so that your tacky tape sticks to your base perfectly. Now it's time to add some papers. So here I have already done the pre-cutting of my papers. These are the beautiful pattern papers, and I am going to have this. Now for the cover page, I'm going to have my first, the pink color cardstock. I am planning to do this in a bit of a shabby chic theme, so I am using the colors accordingly. So what I'm going to do is I will apply a layer of my glue gun just randomly, and then I'm going to stick my paper to this. You just need to press it well so that it sticks well to your project. Now for the next side, I will be sticking this one. So here what I've done is I've taken a floral theme because I wanted a shabby chic project. So but you can choose your papers accordingly. You can choose your pattern papers, designs, everything accordingly, and then you can go ahead and start working on your project. Now for the third sheet. So I am going to use two different papers here, and I'm going to alter the designs, and this is going to be a bit of colorful plus shabby chic, and mostly the shades of shabby chic theme for my project. I'm just taking it in random. There is no particular way that I want my papers to be in this way or that way. I am not going with the alternate paper sticking work. This is just my regular paper work. And done. And now it's time to stick the last page. Just make sure you press it well. And now it's time to stick my last page here. So here my pages are done. I'll just give you a go through. So 1, 2, 3. So this is how I've planned to keep my album, and that's why I have chosen the paper accordingly. That's why I've cut the papers accordingly. Now I'm going to stick my pattern paper on the cover, and for that I have already I already have few of my cutouts ready with me. Now this is going to be more of a layering thing, so before sticking this I am going to make sure that I have my glue gun on the spots so that I can have some of the 3D effect on my page. But I also need to make sure that I don't press this hard so that I have my 3D effect on my album. Now if you see this, can you see the gap here? This is actually going to have some of the 3D effect on my album. Now I'm going to stick another layer. Maybe I can do it other way around. First I will stick this to my sheet. So what I've done is I've chosen the same paper with the alternate design, and I have taken a pink color cardstock, and now I'm going to have this in layers. And like I said, I'm not going to press my glue gun a lot because definitely I want a good 3D effect on my page. And it's done. And now it's time to stick this. And can you actually see the layering in this? And this is just looking good. And with this, my cover layering is done. And this has some really good layering and thickness over here. Now here I have my mudra stamp, and I'm going to use this pink color ink pad and my pigment ink pad, and I'm just going to do some random stamping here and there. But I just want to make sure that I don't overdo the pink color, so I'll just remove the extra and I'll do some basic stamping here. Some more of stamping. You can always remove the excessive color from your stamps. Now I'll move on to the next page. And again, I'm just going to remove all the extra shades. For this, I'll just do some random stamping. Now, why I love stamping, because they are the one of the best fillers what you can have for your projects. And they work fab with any of your projects, be it your scrapbooking or your mixed media. And the filler, as in like wherever you have empty spaces, you can have these stamps, and they are just ready to go. Be it your any theme project, you can choose the ink pads, you can choose the stamps accordingly. Now I'll be using some tinge of copper shade in this, so I will be just stamping that. And just the random stamping here and there. Now as I'm using a copper, it's not a very dark shade here, so I don't need to remove the extra ink, and I can stamp my shades directly. Now it's time to do some stamping on my cover, and just because it is the same stamp, it gels in really well with your project. You really don't have to like choose the colors or the designs where you want to have it. Now I'm done with my stamping, and now it's time to add the embellishments, and this is the best part of doing any of your projects. So here I have selected few of the sentiments, flowers, and I have these bunch of ribbons and laces, and I am going to have this. And now I will put on the music loud, enjoy the music, and see how I assemble my project. Adding these deco stones, and I really love this. Now I think I'm getting addicted to these supplies, and I'm just adding these randomly just to add some tinge of extra 3D effect on my page, and I think this is going to be a really good filler also. So just a few more deco stones, and I think and I think I am done. So with this, my MDF tag album is done, and this is just looking fab, and I hope you'll enjoy this tutorial. If you have any queries, please do comment below. I'll be more than happy to help you guys. And for the materials, I have already listed down in the description box. Do check that, and thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye bye.